Good evening. I'm Jeff Rusak. Communities across the country are reacting to the death of George Floyd after spending nearly 9 minutes with his neck under a policeman's knee in Minneapolis. Tonight, protests are underway in a number of cities across America, including right now here in downtown Buffalo. 7 Eyewitness News reporter Madison Carter is live with the latest.
Yeah, Jeff, right now you can see as we are walking with this demonstration, we are on Elmwood Avenue right now with a very large crowd. You can see people are walking, taking over the entire streets right here. But Jeff, this all started about an hour ago in Niagara Square. Demonstrators actually started there right around 5 o'clock. People were there, they were demonstrating, they were saying, I can't breathe. There was an 8-minute moment of silence while they remember the 8 minutes that George Floyd had a knee on his back in Minneapolis before he died. But then something strange happened. It happened very quickly. We heard sirens off in the distance and organizers told this crowd to disperse. But that's all they said. They didn't tell this crowd where to go. So the crowd took it upon themselves, began walking up Delaware Avenue. We followed them. There was no direction here, Jeff, as to where we were actually going. We walked all the way up Delaware. We turned left past Allen Street, right around Virginia, looped back around. Now we're going back down on South Elmwood Street. Again, there is no direction here. Not quite sure where the crowd is going, but talking to some people before this demonstration really got started earlier today, we asked them, why are you out here? Why did you want to come and demonstrate here in these streets in this square? And they said they want police brutality to stop. They want black men, black women to stop dying at the hands of police. And they were hoping to keep this demonstration rather peaceful. They said they don't want any violence, but some of the direction that they were getting online was really instructing people how to behave if things did become violent. We saw a lot of people when they arrived here putting milk in their backpacks in case of tear gas because it helps with some of the sting. We saw a lot of people, some with staffs and different types of objects, but so far no violence has broken out. People have remained in this large crowd. Again, not sure where we're going. Police only blocked off Niagara Square for demonstrators to freely move, but clearly, we're moving out of Niagara Square. I'm thinking we're heading back there now. We got instructions yesterday. Law enforcement sources told me that they'd be allowed to demonstrate. They just wouldn't be allowed to block traffic or damage property. Clearly, they've been blocking traffic here, but so far, we have not seen any police on site. Police have not stepped in. We haven't really even seen them in the peripherals, but we do know that they are on the perimeter. They're keeping an eye on things from the sky and on the ground. We're also keeping an eye on things. We will bring you all the details we have. Continue to follow us on social media. We'll check back in if we need any updates. Jeff, we'll send it back to you.